Arkansas 20, Texas A&M 10. And I will tell you, brother, I thought this was going to be a bludgeoning from the very beginning. And now I will say this, Arkansas jumped out 17-0. Texas A&M kind of got lucky to get a three on the board before halftime. And then they come out second half. KJ Jefferson gets hurt. Malik Hornsby, redshirt freshman, I believe, maybe just freshman, has to come in and not nearly as efficient. But that Arkansas defense, man, Arkansas, they're top 22. Their starters are as good as almost anybody in the country. Like, they are unbelievable.
They need KJ healthy for next week.
Yes,
he's got to be healthy, or they can't. They can't play.
They play Georgia next week, but they ain't worried about Georgia. Like, they never expected to go in and beat Georgia. They expected to be able to compete with the teams from Texas, and they beat both of them pretty soundly.
I bet right now they believe they can beat Georgia.
I think they feel like they
can. We might not, and the rest of the country might not, but I bet everybody in that locker room believes they can.
Yeah, you ain't wrong about that.
KJ, I want to see Georgia's offense finally go up against a defense like this, because Georgia's offense has gone up against one good defense all year, and they didn't score an offensive touchdown against them, and that's Clemson. And I think this Arkansas defense might be better than that.
Yeah. Jumping in the chat, by the way, Larry Pilgrim said, what another wacky week. The Brown Yeti said, good morning, fellas. And he said, when was the last time Clemson was ranked outside of the top 10? I think it was 2014.
Clemson shouldn't have been in the top 10 this week, guys. This is the problem. Folks are just still betting on laundry. They're just still ranking laundry. That's all they're doing.
Yeah. No, you're right.
I bet Clemson falls to maybe 15. They're not going to fall far because everybody who makes these rankings are just, they got Dabo's 4-inch cock right up their ass. God almighty.
What a wonderful Sunday morning. Matt Miller said, I tried to tell everyone that would listen that Arkansas was a good team after they beat my Longhorns. Now they understand. No, we've known.
Oh, they're definitely the state champs of Texas.
Trevor Shackelford jumped in. Holy cow, I just realized it's Persevere Gary. That is me. I'm now winning cures everything, Gary. So, all right, so back to this Arkansas game. Arkansas had 197 yards rushing on 49 attempts, 4 points per clip. They were highly successful. Texas A&M, the numbers look good. 23 carries, 121 yards, 5.3 a clip. However, you take out that 167-yarder from Isaiah Spiller.
Nothing.
They got nothing on the ground. They got
one busted play. Now, that's the thing about Spiller, though. He has that ability at all times. So I'm texting with a couple of Arkansas guys watching this game, and they're all, as soon as KJ goes down, they all start worrying. They all start panicking. Oh, yeah. And they've seen this story before. And my biggest thing was you don't have to keep scoring. You do have to get first downs. Because if you go three and out and you put your defense on the field over and over and over again, Jimbo's offense this year is not great. But they have talent to be big plays, and they will bust one. And I'm not – as soon as I hit send on that is when Spiller broke through – two missed tackles, and then gone to the house. And I thought, all right, you can't let that happen another time. It's over.
Zach Calzada. Well, here, jump into the chat again. Antoine Johnson said, tell it like it is, Chris. I think he's talking about the Dabo stuff. Matt Miller said, also, how overrated is the offensive genius Jimbo Fisher? No, it's not that. It's not that he lost his starting quarterback. Zach Calzada comes in. He was the backup. 20 out of 36, 151 yards, no touchdowns, one pick. Look, Calzada was not prepared to be the starter yet.
Oh, I don't think Calzada's qualified to be the starter in an SEC offense.
I think he could be if he's developed over time. Like,
all right, going into this season, is there an SEC team not named Vanderbilt that he would be the starter on?
South Carolina?
No,
I think he might be better than Luke Doty.
I don't know that I agree with that.
It's few and far between. Like, if there is one. So, he was not qualified to be the starter right now. And you saw Arkansas's offense fall apart when they lost their starting quarterback as well. So, this stuff happens when you were trying to figure it out on the fly.
When you've built an offense around an individual, and that individual leaves or can't play anymore for whatever reason, everything goes to shit, because you cannot build a new offense in the middle of the season. You don't have the practice time. You don't have the time to do that. You just don't. I know that I'm making excuses for Jimbo because I'm a Jimbo guy, but that's irrelevant. That's also the truth, by the way.
Yes, yes. Matt Miller said A&M has two touchdowns this year, one versus Arkansas, one versus Colorado. He said Haynes King had more interceptions than touchdowns when he played. I'm not saying that Haynes King was great. I'm just saying that the offense looked a little bit more in sync whenever he was in there, and that's why he was the starter. Zach Calzada.
We never got to see that offense, though. We never got to see what it developed into and what it became.
Right. This is the first time Zach Calzada has seen any kind of speed like this in Arkansas. No, yeah. Unreal. I mean, they were fantastic. So. Yep.
We could finish this season with them just under Georgia as the best defense in the SEC.
Oh, it's entirely possible. Barry Odom against an inexperienced quarterback is just a massacre.
It's like, cheat code. It's just not fair. No, I thought Jimbo could hang with Barry. I was wrong.
Yeah, it's not Jimbo. It's that he he just didn't have the guy. He just didn't have
no. Because I'm gonna tell you this: receivers for A&M were open. I mean, he just couldn't make the throws.
Oh yeah.
If guys are getting open but they're not making plays, that's not on scheming. I had this conversation with my Texas A&M, my Mississippi State friends yesterday. Wide receivers were wide open against LSU. There was four or five massive drops. The scheme worked. The coaching did its job. Everything that Mike Leach brings to the table was working. They didn't execute. Either Rodgers didn't make the throw or the receivers didn't make the catch, but they were all wide ass open. So yes. What do you want? How do you want to blame the coaches if players don't execute, but the scheme worked to perfection?
I don't think that you can.
I don't think you can either.
No.
So
thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at Chris B. Giannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.